to this video on Trade Like a Casino Part 2, Creating a Profitable Trading System. I'm Adam Khoo. And a couple of months ago, I created this video, Trade Like a Casino for Consistent Profits. And since then, I've had phenomenal response. We have got almost 250,000 views on YouTube. I've got so many emails sent to me saying, Adam, I finally see the light. I finally realize how professional traders make money consistently. It's not about having luck. It's not about predicting the future. But it's because they've got a statistical edge in the markets. Just like the casino has a statistical edge over the players. So I've created this video to specially show you how you can replicate the business model of the casinos trading from home by creating a profitable trading system. So before I show you how to do that, let's do a quick review of what we've learned in the previous videos. In the previous video, I said that casinos always win at the end of the day. The house always wins. Why is that so? Because casinos have rigged the games such that they have got an edge over the players. So let's take a game like roulette, for example. So many players play roulette because they think, hey, I've got an equal chance of winning against the casinos. It's a luck, right? Either, you know, it's a 50-50 chance. What they don't realize is that, sure, in the short term, the players could win from luck. In the short term, it's all about luck. But in the long run, if they keep playing, they will lose everything they have to the casinos. Let's take a look at why. So in a roulette wheel, you can see that there are 18 red numbers and 18 black numbers. 18 odd numbers, 18 even numbers, right? But there are two green numbers, which is the zero and the double zero. And that gives the casino an edge over the players. Because if you are a player and you bet on black, for example, or you bet on red, what's your chance of winning? Your chance of winning is 18. All right, because there are 18 blacks, there are 18 reds. But the total number of numbers are 38, because you have got the two green numbers. So 18 out of 38, statistically, the chance of winning for the player is 47.3%, less than 50%. But for the casino, they win if the ball lands on red or green, as long as it's not black. So the casino wins 20 out of 38 numbers. So their chance of winning is 52.7%. Now you may say, hey, that's just a small edge. That's all they need, right? So 52.7 minus 47.3 is 5.4%. So what does this mean? This means that over a small number of bets, 10 bets, 20 bets, 30 bets, sure, the players can win. The casinos can lose. But over 100 bets, 200 bets, 300 bets, over a large sample of bets, in the long run, it says that for every $1 that's bet on average, the casino will make 5.4 cents because of that 5.4% edge in the markets. And over $1 million of bets, statistically, the casino will make $54,000. For every 10 million of bets, the casino will make $540,000. So that's why casinos will do everything they can to attract people to play. They say, you know, keep playing, keep playing. They give away free drinks, free hotel stay, free shows. Because if you keep playing, they'll win at the end of the day. So to replicate the business model of the casinos, you have to design a trading system or strategy with a statistical edge, or I like to call it a positive expectancy. So here are the ingredients. First thing is, when you enter the market at a certain entry price, let's call it 50 bucks, for example, you must have a predefined stop loss price and a predefined profit target. So the stop loss price is the price that you will exit if it's a losing trade. And where you place your stop loss depends on the specific strategy. And that's what I teach in the online professional trading course. But let's imagine you place your stop loss at $45, all right? So your risk per trade, or rather your risk per share, is $5. Every share you buy, you're risking $5. So how many shares do you buy? Well, this depends on how much capital you have. So you have to calculate the number of shares you buy using a position sizing formula. You can find in my previous videos, such that in a losing trade, you only lose a small percentage of your capital. And my suggestion is to only limit that to 1% risk of capital. At the very most, 2% if you're more aggressive. And I call this 1R. So 1R represents your risk per trade. At the same time, when you enter a trade, you must have a predefined profit target that gives you an average win more than your average loss. Okay, so if I'm risking $5, I have to make more than $5 if it's a winning trade. So some traders like to put their profit target 1.3R away, or 1.5R away, or 3R, or 2R away. My preference is to place my profit target 2R away from my entry price. So again, 1R is 1% risk, so 2R is 2% return of capital, which means every time I have a winning trade, I'll win 2% return of capital for every 1% I risk. If I'm risking 2% of my capital, I am getting 4% return on capital, okay? So my profit target has to be double the distance of my stop loss. So my profit target would be, in this case, $60, all right? So that's the first key, to ensure your average win is more than your average loss when you have a winning trade and when you have a losing trade. Now the second key is to ensure that you win more than you lose, all right? So you only enter the market when the probability of winning is 50% or more, and the probability of losing is 50% or less. Now, we can't win 100% of the time, right? It's impossible, right? You can't predict the market. In the short term, the market is random in nature. But when you enter the market with a technical edge, by using technical analysis and price action, you can be sure you can get a slightly more than 50-50 chance of being right. And I'll show you how to do that in the videos or the slides to come. So let's take a look at the results of having such a trading system. Now, like I said, a trading system only works over a large sample of trades, just like a casino can only make money when there are enough bets that are placed. So let's take an average of, say, 100 trades. And like I said, we want to be able to be right more than 50% of the time. But let's imagine you're only right 50% of the time, okay? So with that, a 50% win rate, 100 trades would equate to 50 wins and 50 losses. But each time we lose, recall that we lose 1% of our capital because of our predefined stop loss. So that's a total loss of 50%. But each time we win 2% return on our capital because our profit target is double the distance of our stop loss price. So that gives us 100% return on capital. So 100% minus 50% gives you, that's right, a 50% return. So you can see that even at a 50% win rate, we are still getting a 50% return on our capital over 100 trades. So how many trades, or rather, how long does it take to do 100 trades? Well, it depends on your strategy. Whether you are, you know, a swing trader, an intraday trader, a position trader. On average, I do something like about 30 trades a month. So it takes me about 3.5 months to complete 100 trades. And in about a year, I can do anywhere from 400 to 500 trades. So it's a tremendous growth of capital following this system. So for those of you who understand a bit about statistics and probability, let's take a look at how the maths plays out. Now, recall that for every game you play, and again, trading is a game, business is a game, life's a game, you have to always ensure that you've got a positive expected profit per trade. And the formula for that goes this way. It's percentage win multiplied by average win minus percentage loss multiplied by average loss. So in this particular case, our average win percentage is, say, 50%. So 50% of the time, we're going to have a win, and 50% of the time, we're going to have a loss. All right? And when we lose 1R. So we call that 1R represents 1% risk of your capital. Okay? And when we win 2R. Okay? So 50% times 2R is 1R, minus 50% times 1R, that's 0.5R. So that gives you an expected profit per trade of 0.5R. So what does this mean? That means on average, each trade that you place, you're expected to make 0.5R. Just like the casinos know that for every $1 bet, you're going to make 5 cents. Okay? So over 100 trades, you are expected to achieve 50R, right? So 0.5R times 100 is 50R. So what does 50R mean? Again, if you risk 1% a trade, 1R is 1%, that's a 50% return on capital. But if you risk 2%, 1R is 2%, that's 100% return on capital. And in fact, recently, a couple of days ago, I got this email sent to me by one of my students. And after learning my trading system and understanding this concept, he doubled his capital, right? His name is Kenny, and he said, you know, hi Adam, good day. It's been 9 months of live trading. I've officially doubled my initial capital, even though my hit rate is just 50%. I'm really glad I attended the Wealth Academy program last year. It was one of the very few absolutely right decisions I've made. This equipped me with a recession-proof skill set. So this goes to show you, you don't have to be right all the time. You don't have to predict the future. All you gotta do is be right just half the time and control your profits and your losses, and you make consistent profits as a professional trader. People often ask me, Adam, how can you be sure that the probability of winning will be higher than the probability of losing? I mean, isn't it more difficult to hit your profit target, which is further away than your stop loss? Yes, it is if you enter the market randomly. But we will enter the market only if the probability of moving in our direction is higher. And so how do we get this edge to know that price will move in a certain direction with a greater probability? The answer is by studying repeatable patterns of collective human psychology. Remember that short-term, what drives prices is not fundamentals, but it's collective human psychology or emotions or sentiment in the market. So when we can identify these collective patterns that repeat themselves and we exploit these patterns, it gives us high probability outcomes that leads to a statistical edge. So let's look at all the things that will give us an edge in entering our trade. So the first thing would be trends, right? Entering with the trend. So for example, when you can identify that price is on a clear uptrend, making higher highs and higher lows, the probability of price going up on an uptrend is higher than it going down. And we tend to want to go long on the uptrend. At the same time, on a downtrend, when prices make lower highs and lower lows, the probability is that prices will go lower. And that's when we sell or go short. Next, we can look at support and resistance levels. So in this case, you can see a clear support level at about 143. So every time price comes down, it will reverse up, comes down, reverses up, comes down, reverses up. So support levels tell us that there's an imbalance of demand and supply. There's more demand than supply at that price level because buyers are waiting to buy at that level. So the moment the price comes down to that level, what do? That's right, we put a buy order. Now, it's no guarantee that it's going to go up. But because buyers are waiting there, there's a higher probability it's going to go up than going down. So again, it gives us that slight edge. Over many trades, more often than not, it's going to go up. We can also look at trend lines, right? So instead of a horizontal support line, it could be a trend line support. So once you identify a clear trend line support, you can see that when price retraces near the support, it would continue in the direction. Retraces, continues going up, retraces. And again, at this point, what would you do? That's right, you would buy. Because the probability is that prices will go up more than they're going to come down. So once again, that gives us the edge. Next would be candlestick patterns. So again, in my professional online trading course, I show you my favorite candlestick patterns. Whether it's pin bars or one white soldier patterns and morning stars. So here's an example of one of my favorite patterns. The moment you see the price coming down and you see a bullish pin bar with a small body and a long lower shadow, again, there's a high probability that price will start to reverse in the direction of the trend. So that's, again, when we go long, giving us a trading edge. Next, moving averages, right? So moving averages tell us, again, the direction of the trend. When the 50 moving average, the blue line, is above the 150 moving average green line, it's an uptrend, okay? And we want to buy on the uptrend. But moving averages also tell us if price is overbought or oversold, right? So whenever prices move very far from the moving average, it will retrace back to the moving average, right? So whenever price is very far from a moving average, overstretched, the rubber band is going to snap back. So this is when we can sell short, taking a counter trend trade. And whenever the price hits a key moving average and it bounces up, that's when we go long. So we will short over here, we'll go long over here. We go long over here, and go short over there. The moment we see, again, a candlestick pattern that executes the signal. Next, divergence also gives a trading edge. So divergence is when you spot conflict between the price and the indicator, the trends. So on a downtrend, you can see that prices make lower highs and lower lows, okay? But when the indicator makes higher lows, what happens? You have a divergence. So price is making lower lows, indicator making higher lows, a divergence signals a high probability that price will reverse up. Again, at that point, we will go long, giving us an edge in the markets. Next, Fibonacci levels, right? So Fibonacci levels tell us, again, when price tends to reverse. So when you see price making an impulsive move from A to B, and it retraces, okay, to C, it continues, again, the same process, A to B. And when it retraces, if it retraces to a 61.8% level, that is a strong Fibonacci level. So the moment you see that, you know, okay, high chance is gonna continue the trend, and that is again when you go long, all right? You also have got other technical indicators, whether it be MACD or stochastics or many other indicators that give you the edge. And finally, news catalysts. Now this applies especially for intraday trading. When I trade intraday and I scalp the markets, I want some kind of news catalyst, like strong earnings to drive the stock up, all right? So you have to learn to use a combination of these trading edges to give you an overall edge that will beat the market most of the time. Important to know is that these technical signals like candlesticks and support and resistance, they can't be used by themselves. They must be used in the right combination to create a trading system. So let me show you two of the trading systems that I use. One of them is a swing trading system. Another one is an intraday scalping system. So one of the swing trading systems I use is known as the bounce trading system, because I enter the moment the price bounces off a key support level. So in this case, you can see the price moving up, retracing, moving up, retracing. Now, right at this point, there's a strong support. Why? Because it bounces off the moving average. Can you see that? Bounces off the 200 moving average. So that's one edge. Next, notice that this is also a 61.8% Fibonacci level. So that gives me an additional edge. We also have a special candlestick pattern known as the one white soldier pattern. That gives me an edge as well. And finally, at the point of bouncing, this indicator, the full stochastics, is below 30. So that tells me that the price is oversold. It's overstretched to the downside. It's going to snap out. So that's exactly when I'll place a buy order. So once I buy, I anticipate the price will move in my direction. So again, am I going to be right all the time? 100%? No. 70%? No. All I'm looking for is just being right more than 50% of the time. And I know that if I do this consistently, I will always be more than 50% right, because I'm going with the edge of the markets. This is my intraday system, which I call GUNS, because it's called the Gap Up New Scalp. So this is a system which I trade every day when the market opens. And the edge which I use is actually a news catalyst, right? So some kind of news catalyst, like the company announces great earnings. So I know that the price is going to jump at the market open, or the company has raised its forward guidance, or it's got a drug FDA approval, or analysts have upgraded the stock. So the moment the price opens, I know the price is going to jump. I want to get in the moment the price starts opening. So for this, I use the 1 minute candles, right, to catch the initial burst in the stock price because of the buyers who are rushing in to push the stock up. So for this setup, you can see that my buy order is at 71.80. My stop loss is at 71.50, 30 cents away, very tight stop because it's a 1 minute candle. And my target price is about 2.5 hour away, which is about 22 or 72.40 cents. So the moment the market opens, you can see it's a 1 minute candle. It goes up, triggers my buy order, and within the second candle, it triggers my target price. So I'm out of the trade in 2 minutes. right? So this is one of my favorite trading styles. I'm in and out within 1 to 2 minutes every day, and I capture either a 2 hour win or sometimes a minus 1 hour loss. In fact, this trading system that I use has a very high win rate of over 65%, all right? And this is what I teach in level 2 of the professional trading course. So once you've created a trading system, how can you be sure that it's got a positive statistical edge in the markets? Well, the answer is you have to start trading, right? And you have to create a, keep a trading journal, and only when you have a large number of trades of 100 or 200 or 300 trades will you know that your trading system really works, and that over time you're going to achieve consistent profits and results just like the casino runs its games. So let me show you an example of my trading journal and the kind of results that I get over a large sample of trades. Alright, so let me show you my trading journal and how I track the performance of my different trading systems. So over here you see my three swing trading systems that I use. The bounce swing system, the impulse pullback swing system, and the Bollinger mean reversion swing system. And this is over 26 months, which is just over about 2 years. And you can see that, for example, for the bounce system, it goes back to July 2015. And for each month, you can see the total hour generated and the total number of trades. So for example, in July 2015, the bounce system generated 13.5 hour of profit out of 14 trades. And the next month, 25 hour out of 19 trades, and so on and so forth. Now, you can see that on a month-to-month basis, on a small number of trades, you may not always get a positive result or positive R. For example, you can see that in September 2015, for the impulse pullback, this generated a negative minus 3.5 R out of 11 trades. So you can do 11 trades and lose money. Yes, you can, because just like a casino, in a small number of bets, the casino can lose or the casino can win. But over a large number of bets or trades, the casino always wins. All right, you can see there are losing months. But over a large sample, so you can see this is over 481 trades on the bounce system, generating 303 R of profit. Okay, so if you divide 303 by 481, you get an expected profit of 0.63 R per trade. All right, so there's an average of 12 R a month and 19 trades per month. You can see over here for the Bollinger mean reversion system. Now, this is a counter trend system, and this system was started trading September 2016. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 months, it's about 1 year, right? So you can see that over a year, it generated 169 R out of 285 trades. So the expected profit, 0.59 R per trade, all right? And that's the average R per month. So again, if you were to see the month-to-month data, let me click on July, you look at July, for example. This is, again, the Bollinger mean reversion system, which I just showed you. And you can see the results on a trade-by-trade basis. So the first trade was a minus 1 R, so a loss, was a win, a win, a win, a win, a win, 4 wins in a row, break even, a win, a loss, so on and so forth. So if you add up all the wins and losses for that month, it's 15.7 R out of 22 trades. So 15.7 divided by 22, it's an expected profit of 0.71 R. That's 12 wins, 6 losses, 4 break-evens, win rate 67%. So a pretty decent month for this trading system, generating 15 R per month. So if you risk 1%, that's a 15% return on your capital. If you risk 2%, it's a 30% return on your capital in a month. All right. Now if you take a look at June, for example, in June, they were all together 52 trades for this trading system, right? And you can see a win, a loss, win and win, a loss, so on and so forth. If you add it all together, you can see 36 R out of 51 trades, again, a 0.71 R expectancy. 28 wins, 21 losses, 57% win rate. Okay. Now, again, not every month may produce a positive R. Now, May was a negative month, right? If you take a look at May, what do you notice? That's right. Look at the losing trades, right? So you've got a string of losing trades here, string of losing trades here, all the way here, string of losing trades, right? So for May, you can see out of 42 trades, right, you got a negative result. You lost money for that month, right? 13 wins, 26 losses, 33% win rate, right? So traders, some traders, they can't handle this. Hey, if it's a profitable trading system, I should win money every month. No, it doesn't work that way. There are months when over a number of trades, you can lose money, all right? So, but you can be sure that over a large number of trades, over 11 months and 285 trades, you get 169 R. So again, if you risk 1%, that's 169% return on your money. That's more than double your money in 11 months. If you risk 2%, that's more than 300% return on your money, all right? So you can make a lot of money as a trader, but you have to think statistically over a large sample of trades. You cannot have a small number of trades and you lose money and you lose faith, you have got doubt and you give up on the system. Doesn't work that way, right? So this is for my swing trading system. Let me show you my GUNS system. So GUNS is over here and this is my intraday system. So now this particular strategy I use has a much higher win rate, right? You can see these are all the trades that are done. A total of 60 trades I did recently. And the total R generated from all these trades, you can see, let me just, it's 37 R out of 47 trades. Expectancy 0.8 R per trade. 29 wins, 17 losses, win rate of 63%. All right, so pretty good. 37% return for 1% risk. All right, so you can see that when you have a trading system with a positive edge, you are definitely going to make money as you trade. So if it's so simple, why doesn't everyone do this? Why can't everyone do this? Because again, like I said, most amateur traders, they think short term. When they have got a string of losing trades like that, what happens, right? Like they got 5 losses in a row, or 8 losses in a row. That's right, they lose faith in the system. They give up or they change their trading system altogether. And by doing that, they don't stick with a system long enough for the system to give you the results that you want. All right, so you gotta understand that, okay? I hope you've enjoyed the video. If you wanna watch more videos, do click the subscribe button. If you want to learn how to become a professional trader or adopt our powerful trading systems, you can visit piranhaprofits.com that you can see below on the right. If you want to attend our live trading programs at Wealth Academy, you can go to wealthacademyglobal.com. So once again, this is Adam Khoo. Happy trading, and I'll see you in the next video.